Yes, last time we have seen the expression for the velocities after collision in case of an head-on elastic one-dimensional collision. And also we have seen some special cases of that. Let us see some one more special case of that, and then we can move to the two-dimensional elastic collision. Okay. So let us see. Yes, I hope you can see the screen. This is what we have discussed last time, that whenever a ball is just dropped from some height h1, and suppose it rises up to the height h2 after the collision with the surface, then we can just find out the coefficient of restitution of that collision by using this formula, jo ki humne already derived kiya tha. जो आपको पता already, it is E is equal to V1 upon U1. Actually, it is minus of V1 upon U1. But what happens is, since V1 and U1 are opposite in sign, that this minus sign just gets cancelled, and we are left with this formula simply minus simply V1 upon U1, where V1 is the velocity just after the collision, and U1 is going to be the velocity just before the collision. And ratio of these two velocities happens to be the coefficient of restitution. And also that this coefficient of restitution can also be expressed in terms of the heights, as we can see from this. Heights ke form mein bhi hum express kar sakte isko, kyunki U1 is the velocity obtained by the body, which is freely falling from height H1. Agar H1 itne height se koi bhi body agar chhod diya jata hai, to wo H1 itne height niche jane ke baad kitna velocity gain karega, तो वो निकालने के लिए हमारे पास ये फॉर्मूला है, दैट इज रूट ऑफ 2 g h1. अच्छा, ये सबको समझा है कैसे आया वो फॉर्मूला? आई होप यू कैन यू शुड रिमेम्बर व्हाट एवर वी हैव डन इट इन द काइनेमेटिक्स. तो काइनेमेटिक्स के अंदर हमने ऑलरेडी वो फॉर्मूला प्रूव किया है, बट इफ यू वांट यू कैन जस्ट प्रूव इट वंस अगेन नाउ. Okay, so basically we can just prove this formula in a simple technique. एक simple सा तरीका है कि मान लो कि ये ball जो है एक suppose particular height पे है, यहाँ से suppose ये ground है, और अगर ball जो है वो ball यहाँ पे है, ठीक है, और यहाँ से हमने उसको छोड़ दिया. तो जैसे हम छोड़ देंगे तो उस समय उसका initial velocity कितना होगा? Zero होगा, no doubt. It will be zero, and hence it will have the potential energy stored in it. ठीक है ना? तो उसके अंदर जो potential energy stored होगा, तो वही सीधा जाके नीचे, जैसे वो जैसे नीचे जाता जाएगा, तो उसका velocity जो है वो बढ़ता रहेगा. And when it will just about to touch the ground, it will have the maximum velocity there, and that velocity can be obtained by using the potential energy at the highest point equal to the kinetic energy at the lowest point. ये दोनों को equate करने से हमको ये formula मिल जाएगा. अभी देखो, तुमको पता है already what is the formula for potential energy and what is the formula for kinetic energy. तो तुमने ये सुना होगा, the potential energy is given by mgh, correct है? But h is nothing but h1 here. यहाँ से h1 इतने height से अगर ये body नीचे गिरता है, तो इसलिए उसका जो पोटेंशियल एनर्जी है h1 इतने हाइट पे, तो वो कितना होगा? mgh1 के बराबर होगा. सो वी कैन जस्ट से दैट द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट द हाईएस्ट पॉइंट, वी कैन से ए हियर, दिस पॉइंट इज डिनोटेड बाय ए एंड दिस पॉइंट इज डिनोटेड बाय सपोज बी. the potential energy at point A is going to be same as the kinetic energy obtained by the body at point B. And hence, we can just get that potential energy, which is going to be mgh1, should be equal to the kinetic energy at point B. What is the kinetic energy at point B? It is equal to half of m into v square. This formula is kinetic energy. If we just cancel out this m from both sides, then we can be able to get that this 2 is transferred in that side, so that we get this 2gh1 is going to be equal to v square. And hence, we can just get that v is simply equal to root of 2gh1. No doubt. तो लेकिन इस v को हमने एक्चुअली क्या बोल के रखा है, u बोला हुआ है यहाँ पे, जस्ट द वेलोसिटी बिफोर द कोलिजन, इसके लिए उसको हमने u1 बोल के रखा है एक्चुअली, तो इसलिए इसको हम u1 बोल सकते हैं, और ये u1 जो है तो वो हमको इस तरह से भी निकलने आएगा, तो mu square, half mu square will be the kinetic energy obtained by the body at the lowest point, which is going to be, so if you just cancel out m, we can just get that 2gh1 is equal to u square. And if you just take the square root on both sides, we can just get that u is equal to, matlab u1 is equal to root 2gh1, correct? And the same way, if suppose the ball just strikes with the ground and again returns back, then the velocity of the ball just after the collision, so collision ke baad ka jo velocity raha hoga इस बॉल का, उसको अगर हम सपोज v1 बोल देते हैं, और उसकी वजह से अगर बॉल यहाँ पे एक h2 इतने हाइट तक अगर जाके वापिस आता है, इस हाइट पे अगर जाता है, h2 is the height attained by the ball with the velocity v1, initial velocity v1 होने के वजह से h2 इतने हाइट पे अगर वो जाता है, तो यहाँ पे फिर से हम वही बात यूज कर सकते हैं कि the kinetic energy at the point, bottom point, that is B, will be equal to the potential energy at the highest point once again. Okay, that is A, suppose, or C we can say. ये जो highest point है अभी का, उसको हम C बोल सकते हैं. ठीक है, तो C point का जो potential energy है, वो आया कहाँ से? जो उसके पास kinetic energy यहाँ पे था, वहाँ से ही आया. तो इसलिए kinetic energy का formula हमारे पास है, half m v1 square, which is going to be equal to mg into h2 now. And hence this m just gets cancelled. And if we just transfer these two in that side, then we can be able to get that v1 square is equal to 2gh2. And hence v1 can be written to be simply equal to root of 2gh2. Correct? So this is the proof. How can we get this v1 is equal to 2gh2? And u1 can be written to be equal to root of 2gh1. And then we can just be able to talk about this E, which is obtained here. The jo coefficient substitution hota hai, agar h1 height se increase karne ke baad, agar body h2 itne height tak agar chadta hai, to us case mein coefficient of substitution of that collision kitna milta hai? Root of h2 upon h1. Iske barabar mil jata hai. Uska example bhi humne shayad kiya tha last time. If suppose body is thrown or just released from the height h 100 cm, and suppose it just bounce back up to the height of 80 centimeter only, or just 64 centimeter only, then we can just be able to get the coefficient of restitution in that case by using this formula, root of h2 upon h1, where h2 is found to be 64 and h1 is going to be 100, so that we can just get the square root of 64 upon 100, which happens to be 8/10, which is nothing but 0.8 in this. So ye formula hum use kar sakte hain aaram se. Yes, so all these things are already done in last lecture. Now let us see the next concept in this chapter, that is about, yes, okay. तो अभी हमको ये देखना है कि सपोज एक बॉल जो है, तो यहाँ पे सपोज एक बॉल है एंड सपोज ग्राउंड इज देयर एट दिस पॉइंट हियर समवेयर, व्हाट विल हैपन इज द बॉल विल जस्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट स्ट्राइक विद द ग्राउंड. सपोज दैट द बॉल इज एट अ हाइट h0 फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड, यहाँ से ग्राउंड से जो उसका हाइट है उसको हम बोल देंगे एच नॉट. ओके, सो बॉल विल जस्ट ड्रॉप डाउन. तो ये बॉल जब नीचे जाएगा सो इट विल जस्ट ट्रेवल इन डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन एंड विल जस्ट स्ट्राइक द ग्राउंड एट दिस पॉइंट हियर. एंड एज सून एज इट स्ट्राइक्स द ग्राउंड इट विल जस्ट बाउंस बैक. ठीक है ना, यहाँ पे जैसे वो स्ट्राइक करेगा तो उसके बाद वो फिर से ऊपर मूव करेगा. एंड सपोज दैट इन द फर्स्ट अबाउट द ग्राउंड, तो यहाँ पे जो हाइट वो अटेन करता है तो वो सपोज है एच वन. ओके, एंड देन अगेन द बॉल रिटर्न्स इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. सपोज यहाँ से ये बॉल फिर से डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन में जाने लग गया, यहाँ से वो फिर से नीचे की तरफ जाएगा और वही हाइट नीचे ट्रेवल करेगा और जैसे ही नीचे जाके स्ट्राइक करेगा ग्राउंड को साथ तो उसके बाद फिर से वो बाउंस होगा एंड इट विल अगेन जस्ट बाउंस अप एंड विल जस्ट ट्रेवल इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. बट नाउ दिस केस इट विल नॉट ट्रेवल अप टू द हाइट एच वन, बट आफ्टर द सेकेंड कोलिजन इट विल जस्ट ट्रेवल अप टू द अनदर हाइट विच मे बी सपोज टू बी एच टू दिस टाइम. इसको हम एच टू बोल सकते हैं नो डाउट. एंड अगेन at this point it will just start moving in the downward direction after reaching the highest point, and suppose it moves in the downward direction and just strike the ground once again at this point and again bounce back and starts moving in the upward direction, but now again it will not move up to the height h2, even it will just able to reach to the height of h2 h3 only. अब यहाँ पे जो हाइट वो रीच करेगा तो वो एक्चुअली H3 रहेगा, तो उसको हम अभी H3 बोल सकते हैं. एंड आफ्टर दैट अगेन इट विल जस्ट कंटिन्यू द सेम थिंग अगेन एंड अगेन, तो यही चलता रहेगा. फिर यहाँ से चौथे कोलिजन के बाद जो वेलोसिटी वो अटेंड करेगा या जो हाइट अटेंड करेगा उसको बोल सकते हैं H4 लाइक दिस, एंड देन इट विल जस्ट बी एबल टू रीच द हाइट H4 इन दिस वे. And again return back like this. तो यही चलता रहेगा यहाँ पे. और अभी हमको in after nth collision in general, what will be the height attained by the ball and also what will be the velocity attained by the ball, वो हमको निकाल के दिखाना है. ओके, तो अभी देखो ये initial height जो है तो उसको तो हमने चलो डाल दिया h naught. ठीक है, initial just before the collision. But after the first collision, the height attained by the ball will be H1. This is actually H1. Remember, this is going to be H2 here. Okay, this is going to be H3. And this is here. You can just see. It will be H4 and so on like that. So, ye hoga. Abhi ek baat aur humko yahan pe rakhni hai ki suppose its initial velocity, which it attains just before the collision, going to be suppose V0. Okay. इसको हम V naught बोल देंगे. V naught is going to be the velocity just before the first collision, and the velocity after the first collision will be denoted by V1 suppose. तो यहाँ पे इस collision के बाद का जो उसका velocity है उसको हम V1 बोल देंगे. चलेगा ना? ये देखो यहाँ पे जो उसका just collision के पहले वाला जो velocity है उसको हमको V naught बोलना होगा. This is going to be V naught here. It is in the downward direction. But the velocity just after the collision, first collision, is going to be V1 here, no doubt, V1. इसको V1 बोलने का reason भी वही है कि because it is the velocity just after the first collision. That's why I can just characterize it as V1, no doubt. And it will be the same velocity which is the velocity before the second collision here at this point. यहाँ पे जो velocity उसके पास होगा वो भी exact उतना ही होगा, बिल्कुल. But after the second collision, if you want, we can just zoom slightly. ये थोड़ा सा हम zoom कर सकते हैं so that we can just understand carefully. ये देखो, ये first collision, this is the second collision. Now we can just talk about the velocity just after the second collision. How much it will be? So we can just talk about, and it will actually be V2 here. ये सेकेंड कोलिजन के बाद का जो उसका वेलोसिटी रहेगा तो उसको हम V2 बोलने वाले हैं, नो डाउट. एंड V2 इज द वेलोसिटी जस्ट आफ्टर द फर्स्ट कोलिजन एंड इट इज द वेलोसिटी सेम वेलोसिटी व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी बिफोर द थर्ड कोलिजन. ये देखो, ये थर्ड कोलिजन के पहले वाला जो वेलोसिटी है वो भी उतना ही रहने वाला है, दैट इज वी डू, नो डाउट. इसको अलग नाम देने की जरूरत नहीं है, इट विल बी द सेम अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, राइट. एंड अगेन इट विल बी हियर आफ्टर द थर्ड कोलिजन, द वेलोसिटी अटेन्ड बाय द बॉल विल एक्चुअली बी वी थ्री हियर. तो इसको हमको वी थ्री बोलना होगा. ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज वी थ्री. एंड देन इट विल बी अगेन द सेम वेलोसिटी विच इज going to be before the fourth collision actually, and the velocity after the fourth collision we can call it as v4. Okay, v4. And again it is going to be the same velocity which is going to be after the fifth collision, just before the fifth collision, no doubt. So in this way it will be the velocity just before the fifth collision in this way, so no doubt. And then this will continue. But what we want to say here is, ये हमको यहाँ पे समझने जैसी बात ये है कि ये जो nomenclature हमने किया है वो एक खास purpose के वजह से किया है, क्योंकि हमको formula जो बनाना है तो वो याद रखने के लिए हमको एक simple form चाहिए. उसके लिए हमने ये नाम इस तरह से दिए है. वैसे तो कोई भी नाम चल जाते, but we are giving this terminology in order to remember the formula correctly. Okay, abhi if we just focus on the first collision carefully, okay, just focus on the first collision we can say, yes. So first collision ke dauran kya hoga, dekho likhe ke uske collision ke pehle wala velocity kya hai, what is the velocity before collision. It is minus v naught, correct? It can be written as minus of v naught. ये है collision के पहले वाला velocity, minus v naught. But what is the velocity just after the collision? Can you tell me? Velocity after the collision. It is going to be v1. Okay. So therefore, we can just get the formula that is coefficient of restitution, which is going to be equal to, as I have told you already, coefficient of restitution is given by the formula. Simply e is equal to minus of the velocity after the collision upon before the collision. What is the velocity after the collision? Which is v1 here. So this is v1 is replaced here in the numerator, and the velocity before the collision, which is going to be minus of v naught, is going to be replaced here in the denominator like this. And this minus minus sign will get cancelled, and we'll be left with e is equal to, जो e है तो वो हमको v1 upon v0 मिलेगा. बिल्कुल, तो देखो ठीक से ये हमको फॉर्मूला मिल गया फॉर द फर्स्ट कोलिजन, वी कैन से. ओके, व्हाट इज फॉर द सेकंड कोलिजन? इफ वी जस्ट फोकस ऑन द सेकंड कोलिजन के लिए क्या होगा, द वेलोसिटी बिफोर द कोलिजन इज द सेम एज v1 minus of v1 in this case. देखो इसके यहाँ पे ये जो second collision के पहले का जो velocity है वो v1 है, और वो भी minus है क्योंकि वो नीचे की तरफ है, तो इसलिए ये minus v1 बन गया velocity before the second collision. And what is the velocity after that second collision? So it is going to be v2. Okay, so it is v2. And if we apply the same formula once again, that is coefficient of restitution, which is equal to the velocity after the collision upon velocity before the collision, and negative ratio of that. So if you just apply it carefully, then we can just be able to get that minus of, here it is v2, and upon minus of v1, so that we can just be able to get that this will be actually e is equal to, so we can get this e to be simply equal to v2 upon v1. In this way, so we have got the coefficient of distribution from the second collision also, that is v2 upon v1, no doubt. In the same way, we can talk about the third collision here. The third collision ke bare mein kya bol sakte hain, dekho. And after we'll just talk about the third collision, we can generalize the situation for after nth collision. Because agar ek teen collisions ke bare mein jo bhi kuch hota hai, to wahi fir se repeat hone wala hai. अगले आगे कोलिजन के अंदर, तो इसलिए थर्ड कोलिजन के दौरान देखो क्या हो रहा है. व्हाट इज द वेलोसिटी बिफोर दैट थर्ड कोलिजन? so it is going to be minus of v2. Okay, देखो यहाँ पे ये थर्ड कोलिजन है राइट, तो इसके पहले वाला वेलोसिटी कितना है माइनस ऑफ v2 और उसके बाद का वेलोसिटी कितना है v3 है, तो इसलिए फिर इसको हम बोल सकते हैं वेलोसिटी बिफोर एंड हियर द वेलोसिटी आफ्टर, द वेलोसिटी आफ्टर द कोलिजन एक्चुअली विल बी इक्वल टू v3 राइट, एंड हेंस वी कैन जस्ट गेट दैट e दैट इज द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रेस्टिट्यूशन to minus of v3 upon minus of v2, where minus of minus becomes plus and hence e actually becomes equal to v3 upon v2, correct here? And now just compare this formula which you already got here, to yahan pe jo aapko mil rahe hai formula ye sare, to ek check karo ek bar theek se, dekho isko ye pehla wala jo formula humko mila tha इसको मैं ऐसा भी तो लिख सकते हैं कि नहीं, देखो v1 is equal to e times of v0, correct है? Yes, then again here this formula can actually be written to be simply equal to v2 is equal to e times of v1, right? But v1 is already e times of v0, right? So if we just replace it by that, then we can just be able to get that v2 is actually equal to e into v1, where v1 is nothing but ev0, so that we can just get this as ev0, so that we can just get that v2 is equal to e square into v0, correct hai? To ye ek formula humko mil raha hai v2 ke liye, no doubt. So v1 is going to be e into v0, v2 is going to be e square into v0, so what we can expect for v3? E cube into v0, we can just check here v3 is actually going to be v2 into e, right? So that means e into v2, but already we have got v2 in the first previous equation here, ye v2 ka value hamare paas hai already, agar hum wo wahan pe rakh denge to v3 can be written as equal to e into yahan pe v2 ka ke badle kya aane wala hai, e square v0 dalna hai humko, to ye e into e square into v0 agar dal diya idhar to humko kya milega, e into e square becomes e cube, and hence we will be able to get that v3 is equal to e cube into v0, okay? And then now we can just be able to generalize this result and say that what will happen after nth collision, nth collision ke baad kya hoga, what will be the velocity after nth collision, vn we can say, we can just say that it will be e raised to n into v0, check e raised to n into v0, agar ye symbol ek single formula agar yaad kar le ke rakh lo to fir baki koi bhi formula learn karne ki zarurat nahi hai, iske andar sare formula aa gaye, dekho if we just put n equal to 1 here we can just get e into v0 which is the result we obtained here in the first equation here, if we just put n equal to 2 we can just obtain this second equation, if we just put n equal to 3 we can just get this equation and so on like that, no doubt. So ye ek hi formula humko isme andar velocity after nth collision humko mil jata hai isme se, okay? To ye ek baat, dusri taraf aur ek baat humko yahan pe samajhni hai ki we already seen last time that we can also express this e in terms of the heights also, we already proved that the e is always equal to root of the height after the collision upon height before the collision. Now just focus on this diagram. तो यहाँ पे अगर diagram पे अगर ठीक से focus करते हो तो क्या पता चल रहा है यहाँ पे, if you just see in the first collision, तो first collision का अगर हम बात करते हैं तो first collision के पहले वाला height कितना है, h not है बराबर, और first collision होने के बाद कितना height उसने attain किया तो वो h1 है, so we can just say that this h2 h1 upon h0 will be obtained here, it will be used here, so e jo hai wo yahan pe h1 upon h0 hone wala hai, do you agree with this? So this is the another formula for coefficient of restitution, remember. Yes, we'll just make a partition so that we can not confuse. Yes, so here we can just get that e is going to be equal to root of height attained up Detergent upon hello yes so basically coefficient of restitution or for the first collision, if you just see here, then we can just be able to get that before this first collision, the height attained or height of the body was actually h naught, and after this first collision, the height attained by the body was h1. And we already know that the coefficient of restitution is written as root of height after the collision, that is h1, upon the height before the collision, that is h0. This is for the first collision. Again, we can say, after all, the second collision, if you just talk about for the second collision, then we can just see that height before the collision is going to be h1 only. So, yahi height yahan pe before collision, second collision ke liye banega. Or height after the second collision is going to be h2 actually. And hence, the coefficient of restitution obtained from this second collision here is going to be root of h2 upon h1. Correct? Yes, miss, humko mil raha hai. And if we just talk about the third collision in the same way, then we can be able to get that. See here, third collision. So, third collision ke pehle wala height kitna hai? So, ye dekho, h2 hai, right? H2 is the height before the second, third collision. And h3 is the height after the third collision. And that's why h3 upon h2 ka root humko nikalna padega yahan pe. So, coefficient of restitution here in this case can be obtained to be simply equal to the root of h3 upon h2. Do you agree with this? Okay. But if you just see the nature of this formula here, this h1 is going to be common here and here also. Even h2 is going to be common in this formula and in this formula also. So we can just combine this formula using these common facts. So if you just square both sides, then we can be able to get that e square is going to be equal to h1 upon h0, right? And if we just take this h0 in that side, then we will be able to get that h1 is actually equal to h0 into e square. So this is h0 into e square. This is going to be the first formula for the height after the first collision. So see here, the height after the first collision is going to be the height before the first collision multiplied by e square. Ye bahut important result humko yahan pe mil gaya. Abhi isko agar hum yahan pe use karenge, aur wahi same agar yahan pe is equation ko bhi agar karenge, if you just square on both sides, then we can be able to get that e square is going to be actually equal to h2 upon h1. Correct? And if we just take this h1 in that side, then we can be able to get that h1 into e square is going to be h2 simply. And hence we can just get that h2 is going to be h1 into e square. Correct? But already we have proved that h1 itself is h0 into e square, right? So if you just put this value of h1 here, then we can be able to get that h1 ke badle h0 into e square humne dal diya. Aur ye bracket ke bahar jo ye e square hai wo, okay, so is bracket ke bahar jo e square already hai, it will be kept as it is here. So we can just keep it as it is, e square. And just if we just multiply this e square and e square together, then we can be able to get this e raised to 4 here. And hence we can just get that h2 is equal to h0 into e raised to 4. Check. This is going to be actually the second equation we can obtain here, which is the height attained by the body after second collision. And in the same way, if we just do it here, if we just square on both sides, then we can get this e square, which is going to be equal to h3 upon h2, so that h2 can be transferred that side, so that we get this h3 is equal to h2 into e square. But e square, h2 is already there. See it here. This is h2. So if we just put it here, then we can be able to get that h3 is going to be equal to h2 which is replaced by H naught into e raised to 4, and that is multiplied with e square again. So that if we just combine this e square and e raised to 4 here, then we can be able to get that H3 is actually equal to H naught into e raised to 6 actually. According to the laws of indices, you can just get that e raised to 4 into e raised to 2 becomes equal to 4 plus 2. E raised to 4 plus 2, matlab e raised to 6. This is the height attained by the body after the third collision precisely. And hence, now we can be able to generalize this statement. So just see here, H1 is H naught into e square. H2 is equal to H naught into e raised to 4. H3 is equal to H naught into e raised to 6. Can't we find that the number which appears at the power of e here is just double of this number which appears here as a suffix of H here. Just like here, here is H2. So, usme H ke niche kya hai? 2 hai, lekin. So, uski wajah se yahan pe ye jo hai 4 yahan pe mil gaya. Okay. So accordingly, here we can just get that this 3, ये जो यहाँ पे 3 होता है, तो उसका double यहाँ पे मिलता है, 6 जो कि यहाँ पे. तो इसलिए in general what we can say is the height attained after nth collision, hn we can denote it by, is going to be equal to h naught into e raised to 2n. This is a single formula in which all these formulae are just built in. So we need to remember this, only these two formulae, Hn and Vn. So Hn is going to be equal to H naught into e raised to 2n, whereas Vn is going to be equal to V naught into e raised to n. So dekho, e ke form mein humne Vn or Hn ko express kiya. So this formula is just summarized form of this whole discussion we have just done today. Okay. तो ये पूरा जो डिस्कशन हमने किया है इसका ये दो ही फॉर्मूले समराइज फॉर्म में है. अभी इससे भी और एक थोड़ा आगे जाके हम एक इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट देख सकते हैं कि इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय द बॉडी. सी हियर, वी ऑलरेडी प्रूव दैट इफ सपोज द बॉडी इज रिलीज फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट हियर, देन इट विल जस्ट ट्रेवल अ डिस्टेंस एच नॉट ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट कोलिजन. Then again, it will just make a collision and just rebound back and attain the height h1. So it will travel a distance of h1 after the first collision. Again, we'll just move in a downward direction and then again reach at this point and travel a distance h1 further. And again, when it will rebound from this surface here, it will again travel a distance of h2 this time. So here, wo h2 itna distance travel karega. And then again, it will just go down and rebound back, travel the distance h2, and after collision, it will just travel a distance h3, and so on like that. So if we just find out the total distance traveled by the body, agar humko total distance traveled by the body agar nikalna hai, to kaise nikal sakenge? Total distance will be, dekho, before first collision, the distance traveled is h0. We have to take it into account plus the distance traveled after the first collision is h1 and h1 again. So we can just add it together and call it as 2 times of h1, no doubt. Again, if we just focus on this second collision, the second collision ke baad ke jo do distances hai, h2 and h2, we can just add them together and get this 2 times of h2. And then in the same way, we can just get every pair like this. So every time we can just get the pair only. So these 2 times of H3, then 2 times of H4, 2 times of H5, and so on up to infinity. Abhi, practically, the ball just stops after a certain number of collisions. But theoretically, the process will just continue for infinite times. So ye process jo hai, wo theoretically infinite time tak continue hoga. The ball will just never stop bouncing. So, in this case, we can see that if we just try to express everything in terms of H0 alone, then we can be able to get that this H0 plus 2 times of h1 is already proved to be equal to h0 into e square. Just remember from the previous screen. Okay. Again, 2 times of h2 is just able to h0 into e square ka square. Matlab e raised to 4 ho gaya wo. Then again, it is h 2 times of h3, which is going to be h0 again into e raised to 6, and so on like that up to infinity. So if we just think of this as a simple side, yeah, समझ सकते हैं. If we just take अभी ये देखो 2h not इधर है, 2h not इधर भी है, 2h not इधर भी है, but only the difference is that there is no 2h not here in the first step. So let us add and subtract h not so that this will get completed. यहाँ पे अगर हमने plus इस पूरे system में अगर एक h not add किया और एक बार subtract किया तो कुछ फर्क तो नहीं पड़ेगा, लेकिन हमारा फायदा ये हो जाएगा कि this h not will just be get combined with this h not here, so as to become 2h not, and hence we can just be able to get that all the terms will contain 2h not. So here it will be, or we can just do one thing. चलो ठीक है. So we can just say that is 2 times of h not left here plus 2h not into e square plus 2h not into e raised to 4 plus again 2h not into e raised to 6, and that adds up to infinity. Okay, remember that this is going to be up to infinity, and that is whole thing in the bracket, and then we have to subtract h not from this. Okay, so this is going to be the, but if we just take h 2h not common from this whole bracket, then we can be able to get that 2h not inside the bracket, it will be 1 plus e square plus here it will be e square ka square, matlab e raised to 4. Again here it is going to be e square cube, and e square the whole raised to 4, and so on up to infinity like this. And already we know already that this e is less than 1, and we already seen it maths in arithmetic progression, whenever there is a series which includes geometric progression jo hota hai, geometric progression जिसके अंदर अगर मान लो कि उसका जो कॉमन रेशियो है वो अगर लेस देन आर होता है, तो उस केस में हम ये देख सकते हैं कि इसको ऐड करने के बाद इनफिनिट टर्म्स का जो सम है, मतलब ए प्लस एआर प्लस एआर स्क्वायर प्लस एआर रेस टू 4 एंड सो ऑन अप टू इनफिनिटी हैपेंस टू बी एक्चुअली सिंपली ए अपॉन 1 माइनस आर. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द सम टू इनफिनिटी व्हिच इज ऑलवेज डिनोटेड बाय एस इनफिनिटी हियर, ए अपॉन 1 माइनस आर. A matlab first term and R is the common difference. So if we just use it here, then we can be able to get that this 2h not as it is into here first term is 1. So here it will be 1 upon 1 minus R. R matlab e square here. So this e square is replaced here. And then we can be able to get that minus h not is kept as it is. So if we just simplify this further, then we can be able to get that the final result. So agar humne h not isme se common le liya to dekho humko andar kya bachega, h not common liya to ye 2 jo hai upar chala jayega aur humko milega 2 upon 1 minus e square minus 1, and if we just simplify this still further, then we can be able to get that h not in bracket here it is 2 minus 1 minus e square upon 1 minus e square kept as it is, and which is going to be actually equal to h not kept as it is, and here it is going to be 2 minus 1 plus e square, right, upon 1 minus e square, which actually happens to be, so the total distance traveled by the body, that is s, will actually be given by h not into bracket mein kya aayega dekho, dekhiye ये 2 माइनस 1 क्या बन जाता है, 1 बन जाता है, तो इसलिए वजह से यहाँ पे आएगा 1 प्लस ई स्क्वायर अपॉन 1 माइनस ई स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द इम्पोर्टेंट रेडीमेड फॉर्मूला for finding the total distance traveled by the ball after jumping infinite times. Okay, तो infinite times जब वो इस तरह से bounce करेगा या collision करेगा तो total distance उसके द्वारा जो travel किया जाता है तो वो इस formula से हमको दिया जाएगा. तो याद रखो ठीक से ये formula and this will be the final result, no doubt. Yes, I thought. Yes, right, correct. अथर्व actually maths के अंदर भी कोई कई सारे physics के कुछ formulae use करने पड़ते हैं जरूर. Actually physics and maths is not different, they are very closely related with each other. Maths के अंदर का हर एक chapter, हर एक topic physics के लिए बना हुआ है. मतलब physics के अंदर जो हमको problems आते हैं तो वो problems को solve करने के लिए हम मैथ्स के अंदर बहुत सारे जो टॉपिक्स है उनका इन्वेंशन करते हैं, नए नए प्रॉब्लम्स इन्वेंट करते हैं. और जब वो इन्वेंट होते हैं तो वो इन्वेंशंस मैथ्स के अंदर के सिर्फ वो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व नहीं करते जिसके लिए हमने उसको इन्वेंट किया था, बल्कि कई सारे उस टाइप के बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम्स सॉल्व कर देते हैं फिजिक्स के अंदर के. तो फिजिक्स एंड मैथ्स के अंदर बहुत डीप कनेक्शन है. दैट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, वी कैन जस्ट डिस्कस इट लेटर ऑन. And you will just reveal that relationship between physics and maths up till 12th standard, in the end of 12th standard. 12th standard ke end tak aapko physics aur maths ke beech mein ka jo deep connection hai, to wo aapko surprising cheeze jo hai wo pata chalti rahegi aage chalke bhi, no doubt. So remember this formula as a formula for total distance traveled by the ball after infinite collisions. Remember, this is the formula for total distance covered by the ball. Okay, it's not the formula for displacement actually. If it is a displacement, then it is going to be different. Okay, displacement जो है वो अलग ही आने वाला है. Displacement के अंदर क्योंकि वो जो ऊपर नीचे जो आने वाला है, वो उसमें count नहीं होता. So displacement is going to be h not only because the ball after number of collisions is going to stop and it is going to be at the ground only. So final destination is that and initial destination is this one here. So therefore displacement की अगर बात करते हैं तो it's going to be h not only. But if we just talk about distance, then that can be found out by using this formula and it depends on the coefficient of restitution completely. ये coefficient of restitution के ऊपर ही depend करता है बिल्कुल. तो ये हमको समझना है अच्छी तरह से. Okay, so that's all about this topic we have discussed today. Now we next topics जो है तो वो हम next lecture में कल के lecture में discuss करेंगे, जो कि the collision in two dimensions. तो two dimensional collision उसको हम बोल सकते हैं. That will be discussed in the next lecture. अच्छा एक बात याद रखो.